Welcome to PyMOL 101 with Molecular Memory. Today we'll be learning about the molecular interactions that stabilize secondary structure. We'll use the structure from last time. These proteins interact to modulate the movement of bacterial flagella. And as an added bonus, they contain all the basic secondary structure elements I want to teach you about. Load the structure as usual, 1A0O, and display the sequence. Now, color by secondary structure. We're going to keep coming back to this view to explore the different types of secondary structure in this model, so let's save a scene. Scene drop-down menu, store, F1. Right-click on F1 and rename it. I'll call it overall. We'll explore an alpha helix first. Let's rotate and try to find the longest one. Maybe this one? Click on a residue in the helix. Notice how we see a highlight on the sequence display, but the scroll bar is outside of it. Scroll until we can see the residues we've selected. Great, now let's expand our selection by clicking and dragging over the other residues that make up this red-colored helix. Now one of my favorite command combos, SELEH unselected. Then rename the selection to helix to save it. Helices have distinct hydrogen bonding patterns involving their backbone atoms, which PyMOL calls the main chain. We'll need to see the oxygen and nitrogen atoms to show this. Let's color the helix with CPK coloring and show sticks. I'm going to make sure my N-terminus is on top by clicking on the leftmost amino acid in the sequence and center it. All the backbone carbonyls, C double bond O groups, now point downward. They'll hydrogen bond to a nitrogen atom of another amino acid. If it's an alpha helix, the hydrogen bonding will follow an I+4 pattern. This means the residue closer to the N terminus hydrogen bonds to the residue that's four positions away. For example, if it's residue 100, it'll hydrogen bond to residue 104. Let's add these backbone-backbone interactions. Find polar contacts just intra main chain. Okay, it's more than expected, but it's hard to see anything at all. Let's start by hiding the cartoon. Still pretty busy and overwhelming. Since it's only the main chain interactions we're looking for, let's also hide the amino acid side chains. Okay, that's better. Now let's analyze a residue making only one contact to determine the type of helix. Click on the two interacting atoms, and the residues will highlight in the sequence. It's K122 interacting with K126. 122 plus 4 is 126, so this is indeed an alpha helix. We're also just seeing some secondary close contacts with all these lines. Let's produce an image that shows only the main stabilizing interactions for an alpha helix. Now, we don't want all these secondary measurements. We can use the measurement wizard to pick only the interactions we want to show. In the drop-down menu, wizard, measurement. We can now trace over the vertically oriented I+4 interactions. When we deselect the main chain polar contacts, we see the I+4 interactions we've measured. If we measure the whole helix, there are going to be a lot of measurements that fill up the whole names panel. We've got a couple options to neaten this up. You can group objects in the names panel. So let's take measure 1, A, group, new group. Now let's add measurement 2 and 3 to the group. Now we can operate on the grouped objects together. Let's recolor them. There's another way to achieve this that I really like, but if you misclick, you'll have to start over. First, let's delete our grouped object. Now, the purple parts of the measurement wizard have built-in menus. Click on Create New Object and change this to Merge with Previous. Now, I'll start where we did before for the first measurement. Then, carefully rotate to capture the others. Notice there's just one measurement in the names panel, and we're adding to it. Let's rotate and try to measure them all. Okay, I think we've got them. Click done. And now we have one clean object that I'll rename to helix measure. A lot of work went into that rendering. Let's save a scene. I'll call my scene helix. Now, let's use the scene we saved before to go back to the overall structure. Reposition the structure to show one of the sheets and save a quick scene. The arrows that appear on sheets in PyMOL point toward the C terminus. Notice the strands of the sheet run in opposite directions. Now let's compare this to the other sheet in the structure. They're running in the same direction. This type of beta sheet is called parallel. Let's go back to the first sheet using our scene. This one is called antiparallel. The anti indicates the sheets are running in opposite directions. Let's dig into these sheets to see what this means structurally. Click on one amino acid in it and use that to locate the strand in the sequence. Okay, the sheet we want is in chain B. Select all of the yellow amino acids by clicking and dragging on them in the sequence. Hide unselected, and then rename this selection anti. Show sticks, and color with CPK coloring. Ooh, when I try to move this, it's a little wonky. So let's use the A button to center the selection. Notice where the side chains are relative to the backbone atoms. Then hide the side chains and the cartoon. Now find polar contacts just intra main chain. There they are. Notice again, these are between a carbonyl oxygen and the NH of the backbone nitrogen. We don't see the interacting hydrogen atoms. Go ahead and save a scene. Onto the parallel sheet. Return to our main scene and click on a residue within it. Find it in the sequence, and then select all yellow residues in chain A. Hide unselected, save the selection by renaming it, and then zoom. Show sticks and apply CPK coloring. Again, we'll use polar contacts to show the hydrogen bonds. Actions, find, polar contacts, just intra main chain. Hide the side chains and hide the cartoon. Now save a scene called parallel. Using the stick rendering, the way we can tell this is a parallel beta sheet is by examining the amide linkages, also called peptide bonds in a protein. Look for the carbonyl on one strand and find the nitrogen directly bonded to it. It's on the left in this view. Now look at another chain. This nitrogen is also on the left. The nitrogens are on the same side of the carbonyls, so the strands are running in the same direction. This is a parallel beta sheet. Return to the antiparallel scene now and repeat this analysis. On this strand that's positioned near the top, the nitrogen is to the right of the carbonyl. On the next strand, here's a carbonyl, and the adjacent nitrogen is on the left. The strands run in opposite directions in this antiparallel beta sheet. And that's our lesson on measurement and secondary structure. I hope you learned something.